worship today and be reminded that this morning is the first Sunday of the month of March. The Lord brought us through the month of February. Let us give a clap of appreciation. Thank you, Lord. And as we enter this new month of March, let us depend on the Lord. Please pray with me. Lord, we enter your house today asking for your mercy. Ang bulan sa Marso, so many things we are absolutely clueless of what's going to happen. Pero you are the God who knows everything, and with that, we bow down to you in worship. May we focus on your word, prayer, and then communion. Remind us, O Father, that this is done in remembrance of Jesus. Refresh your people. Bless Kate as she leads us in worship and the team. In the name of Christ, amen. Amen. Please remain standing. Let us all worship the Lord. Kate will lead us in worship this morning.
His name together.
Yeah.
Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless His name. Tell of His salvation from day to day. Declare His glory among the nations, His marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. I approach the throne of glory. Nothing in my hands I bring, but the promise of acceptance from a good and gracious King. Yes, Lord, we worship You. I will give to You my burden, as You give to me Your strength. Come and fill me with Your Spirit as I sing to You this praise. You deserve the greatest glory, and overcome I lift my voice to the King in need of nothing. Empty-handed I rejoice. You deserve the greatest glory, and overcome with joy I sing. By Your love I am accepted, 'cause You're a good and gracious King. Sinners, thank You, Lord. Oh! to stand. I am crucified with Christ, therefore I no longer live. The wonderful cross that bids us to come and die that we might truly live.
Pray. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, we bless your name. Lord, thank you for reminding us of the cross. We don't just mean the wood, we mean the person that died there without sin, Christ. Lord, long time ago, the cross is a symbol of death and capital punishment. But when we view it It's a symbol of chance, a reality that people who fail can find hope in Christ who is righteous. So Lord, as we partake communion a little later, remind us that we are not partaking as guilty criminals, but forgiven sinners. Now called saints, sons and daughters of Abba by faith in Christ. Feed us from your word, invite us to prayer, invite us to listen, invite us to call upon your name. In the name of Jesus, amen. Please be seated. It is good to see you in God's house today. Today is the first Sunday of the month, and we will all have a communion. And you're also aware that this is also the season of Lent. Ibig sabihin, malapit na po ang mahal na araw. Many people are asking what are the activities for the church. We will have our Friday service, 5:30, but there is something I want to propose to the entire congregation that on Holy Thursday, we will have a day of prayer. What do you mean by that? No service, no pastor will stand, but we are inviting you. I commit myself to be there. Give at least 30 minutes to 1 hour to come to church just to pray. Is that okay? Just if you 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. along that line, pamili lang, asang lugar imong gusto, no one will disturb you. Sit down and spend time with the Lord. 30 minutes to 1 hour. I assure you, that is too short for the many, many things we still need to commit to the Lord. Amen? So, I think that's a fair deal enough. We don't do that to earn our salvation. We don't do that so that God would to earn His favor. We do that because God favored us already. Amen? And the blessing of salvation is not just going to heaven. The blessing is Christ Himself. Amen. So I am excited. That would be Holy Thursday. I'm a morning person, so I might come earlier. Go as early as 5, though 6 pa mag-open. Pero if you come early, that could be arranged. Pray for this month. Starting March 9, starts our baptism class. So far, we have dati sana 112, but 2 people back out. So 100 people to be baptized. To God be the glory, no? So pwede pa, 2 more slots are open in the next batch na lang. Your class will start Thursday this week, 6 o'clock at the 6th floor. Let's read this verse before we come to God in prayer. Acts chapter 3, verse 1, all together. Peter and John went to the temple one afternoon to take part in the 3 o'clock prayer service. That's not a doctrine, that's a report of an event, but it inspires us how prayer is so important to the apostles, not only as Jews, but as believers in Christ. And if you look at the verse, it's a beautiful example of leaving your closet, though the Lord Jesus Christ said, in your closet you pray alone, but when you come out of your closet, we learn to pray alone. So 3 o'clock ang ilang schedule, and they are there, not to preach, not to do anything else, though the whole chapter will tell you a lot of activities will follow that, but Peter and John went to pray. I challenge the church, when you come to church, there should be a time of prayer. Proverbs 3, 5 to 7, we will read that text 3 times, okay? 1, 2, 3. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek His will in all you do, and He will show you which path to take. Don't be impressed with your own wisdom. Instead, fear the Lord and turn away from evil. Second reading. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek His will in all you do, and He will show you which path to take. Don't be impressed with your own wisdom. Instead, fear the Lord and turn away from evil. Third and last reading, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek His will in all you do, and He will show you which path to take. Don't be impressed with your own wisdom. Instead, fear the Lord. Turn away from evil. As we have read the passage three times, is there a line, a word, or something that God highlighted in you? If there is, pay attention to those words because God is at work reminding you of something. I can share mine. I've been reading that scripture since this morning, since this week, pero balik-balik yod sa kuha, maybe this is my issue. The Lord reminded me, do not be impressed with your own wisdom. So timely. When we come to the Lord in prayer, you do not come able, we come unable, we come powerless. Do not be impressed with your own wisdom. Maybe sa inyo, God reminded you, trust in the Lord. Maybe others, God reminded you, seek His will, and He will show you the right path. So in prayer, we'll meet God. We will be singing one more hymn to prepare us for prayer, and then preaching, and then end the service with Holy Communion. All rise, please. Kate will be leading us in this song of preparation.
Stormy child who sends the way.
Please be seated and let us come to the Lord in silence and in humble prayer. Everybody will spend time in praying. Talk to God, tell Him your problems, talk to Him in English, Cebuano, your heart language. The Lord will hear us. Lift up our burdens, show us godly perspective, equip us grace so we can face life with lesser demands and more faith. In the name of Christ, amen. Lately, I realized that when we gather together for worship, we have time to pray for our own needs, we have time to pray for the needs of others, and we have time to pray for the suffering humanity. Pero meron tayong nakalimutan. We forgot to recognize that God is still the God of celebration, the God of who releases favor. Ibig sabihin, dili lang tanan sa kinabuhi, problema, naapoy, panalangin in between. Such as, this week is your birthday between now and next Sunday. This week is your anniversary. Or, alam ko every day thankful naman ta sa Ginoo, pero lahig yun this week. Pastor, the Lord blessed my business. I passed the exam. I went through a lot of trial, but before the weekend, I had what a relief. If you are in that category, celebrating something to thank God for, will you stand and we will offer that to the Lord? By standing, you're saying, I'm celebrating. I'm blessed. I'm just thankful to God I'm alive today. Parang ganon, you know? Maybe you had quarrel with your wife 2 weeks ago. Now you're okay. That's something to say, thank you, Lord. Amen. No? Something. Your son or daughter was sick and now they're fine. God be praised. Lord, you are the God of celebration and we stand. Thank you for the material blessing. And above all, those who are celebrating birthdays, thank you for the extended life. Celebrating wedding anniversaries. Oh God, give us wisdom to maximize this occasion and enjoy a date or affirmation. Father, nakalusot yud mi niining si Manaha. We have no idea what others went through, but God, I am just so grateful this week is over. And last week, tremendous problem, maybe in business and dealing with relationship. But Lord, I'm standing now. Thank you. Even favorable result of lab tests, we give you praise, we give you praise, we give you praise. Enter his gates with thanksgiving in your heart. Enter his courts with praise. In the name of Christ, humbly we pray. Amen. Please be seated. I am sure the Lord is honored. Starting today, sali na natin yan. Every time we pray, a time to give thanks or celebration. You know, you're in church to give things. Now this time, those of you who need prayer is the opposite of the first. I'm really having a hard time. Pastor, I'm really having a hard time. Would you please remember in prayer? If you are in that category, would you stand? We will pray for you. Life is not really good to me. Parang stress, work. Yeah. Kanina, I want to stand, but Lord, I cannot now. I'm free to stand because I'm really struggling. Yeah, we will pray for you. This is God's house. No need to be embarrassed. Pastor Jerry will lead us in prayer, interceding, praying for those of us who are standing.
Let us pray. Our Father, we cast all our cares upon you. We ask for healing for our sick bodies. We believe you are still the same God who heals. But for those sickness, Lord, that we have to deal with for the rest of our lives, sustaining grace. Provision for medications, Lord, grant us. Provision for financial needs, we ask, Father, your gracious hands. Maybe some of us are struggling with worry right now because this coming week we have a financial commitment and we don't have the resources yet. Abba, have mercy. Supply our needs. Lord, one of the toughest problems to deal with is broken or conflicted relationships. We pray for resolution, for reconciliation if possible. But Lord, for relationships like this that have immediate resolution, we pray for grace. We pray for wisdom. We pray for humility and patience. Lord, we pray that you renew our spirit because some of us may be spiritually dry. We're struggling with spiritual dryness. We feel you're so far. But thank you, Lord, for the promise of your love that is unchanging. Help us to rest in that love. Lord, for those who are stressed out in their work, we pray for renewed strength, extra grace. For those who lost their job, we pray for hope that comes from you. We cannot name every need, Lord, but you know every need. And we cast all our burdens upon you. Guidance for those who are making decisions. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. If you know someone who needs prayer, kahapon ay my heart is crushed because young person has to undergo chemo treatment. That's tough. Every time they are in church, you just feel their pain. Parang ganon. Do you know someone in that area? This is not yours, but a friend, maybe a family friend, or a stranger. Or while I'm speaking now, the Lord puts a name in your mind. Obey that. That's the Holy Spirit. Maybe a whisper. Pray for your son right now. He's obey you. This is not a joke. God wants you to pray. You have to be in the interceding part and say, Lord, please stand if you have to represent someone who is in pain, especially those who are undergoing medical treatment. Pray for them. The Lord allows you to know their situation so you can pray. People having a hard time, Lord, hear our prayers. While I'm speaking now, maybe there's a name in your mind. Stand and connect and we will be praying. Friend who just, you know, mga bugat na gyud ba? Pastor RC will lead us in this prayer of intercession.
Let us pray. Our Father, you said in your word that intercessions be made for all men. Lord, we just brought our needs, but not just our needs, but the needs of others. And so, Lord, we lift up to you those who are seriously ill, friends of ours, loved ones who are really struggling with physical pain. Lord, we pray for your healing grace. not just physical pain, but those who are also going through emotional pain brought about by complicated relationships, perhaps in marriage, relationship between parent and a child. We ask, Lord, for wisdom as to how you'll be able to restore this relationship, dear Father. And Lord, those of us who are need to make an important decision, maybe to open a business, apply for work, or maybe even to go abroad, Lord, I pray that they will seek you. And as they wait, dear God, may they grow closer to you and deeper in their relationship with you. We continue to pray for the victims of the recent flood and fire here in Davao. O Lord, help them to get back up, to pray that you will meet their needs, dear Father. And also, we pray for those who are struggling in their faith. Pray that you would restore their worship. And those who are struggling with worry, O God, pray that you will indeed bring them back to trusting you. Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayers. And we commit this all to you in Christ's name. Amen.
Please all rise. Pastor Jerry will lead us in the reading of the scripture. If you are with us Sunday after Sunday, we will now conclude our study in the book of Colossians in the fourth chapter.
Together, let us read Colossians 4, 7 through 18. Tychicus will give you a full report about how I am getting along. He is a beloved brother and faithful helper who serves with me in the Lord's work. I have sent him to you for this very purpose, to let you know how we are doing and to encourage you. I am also sending Onesimus, a faithful and beloved brother, one of your own people. He and Tychicus will tell you everything that's happening here. Aristarchus, who is in prison with me, sends you his greetings, and so does Mark, Barnabas' cousin. As you were instructed before, make Mark welcome if he comes your way. Jesus, the one we call Justus, also sends his greetings. These are the only Jewish believers among my co-workers. They are working with me here for the kingdom of God, and what a comfort they have been. Epaphras, a member of your own fellowship and a servant of Christ Jesus, sends you his greetings. He always prays earnestly for you, asking God to make you strong and perfect, fully confident that you are following the whole will of God. I can assure you that he prays hard for you and also for the believers in Laodicea and Hierapolis. Luke, the beloved doctor, sends his greetings, and so does Demas. Please give my greetings to our brothers and sisters at Laodicea and to Nympha and the church that meets in her house. After you have read this letter, pass it on to the church at Laodicea so they can read it too. And you should read the letter I wrote to them. And say to Archippus, be sure to carry out the ministry the Lord gave you. Here is my greeting in my own handwriting, Paul. Remember my change. May God's grace be with you. God bless his words.
Please be seated. This morning, my sermon is very timely. Before we partake Holy Communion, in my relationships, Lord, be glorified. Let me just remind you, in case you forget, that you cannot partake communion if you refuse to release your bitterness to the Lord. Amen? Copy? You cannot partake communion if you are not willing to be forgiving to others. I'm sure there are relationships that cannot be fixed right now, but God wants a heart that is willing to release all our bitterness. Hurt is normal. I get hurt, you get hurt. But when hurt is not addressed and surrendered to the Lord, it becomes bitterness. So before we exciting message today, text your friends, text your family in advance. Madugay-dugay meron ha, mga alas dos na tamaka uli. No, so alas dos is another service, but give me time to, it's really, I need time to expound the message today. But before that, I'd like to ask Kate to lead us in one hymn, a childhood hymn we have always sung in Emmanuel where we grew up. Let others see Jesus in you. Amen. All rise, please, as we sing this song of preparation. Message today is not only necessary that you hear, and I assure you, I don't preach this without a struggle because it's about handling relationships. In this last segment of Paul's epistle to the Colossian church, he mentions a lot of names, and I think the outline goes this way, names and an explanation, names, explanation. A lot of names and along with it, some few comments about the names mentioned. Generally, those names mentioned are Paul's ministry friends and partners. Here is an obvious lesson for all of us. Paul related with others. You cannot survive the Christian life solo. You need to relate with others. And in the many webs of relationships, it molded him to be a person, and as he too mentored others. Believe me, I am aware that not all our relationships are sweet. Amen. Nagyo'y mga, alam mo na, the reality of it, like you were friends before, you're enemy now, that's why the term frenemy, ay inakumbay na karon, no? Frenemy, parang true lies, naunsa na. I mean, no, how do you describe that? We are friends and we become enemy, that's a relationship. Whatever God allowed in your life, believe me, I bleed when I say this. But I want to look at it in the perspective, not of disclaimer or just simply, simplistically touching a fragile point of life, but rather by faith, believe that whatever happened in the relationships God allowed in my life, that contributed for my great need to trust God even more. All God's people say. When we talk about relationship, we don't only mean church. We mean workplace. We mean family. We mean Facebook. Relationships. One of the most fragile aspects of the, and especially in ministry and the Christian life, is in the area of building authentic relationship. Now you know where I'm going. You want to glorify Christ in our relationship? You and I are not called to be isolated. We need to blend. And the goal is to build authentic relationships that honors Christ. Kumpleto ha? Some relationship must be built because of business interests. Some relationship must be built because of agenda. Pastor David reminded me that he is so somehow touched with a statement that we've said. Mabuti naalala ko ngayon. Last Saturday night or Friday night, anyone who is not willing to surrender personal agenda is unable to build authentic relationship. You have to surrender personal agenda in order for you and me to enter into the life of another one. Of course, not as a great crusher, but permission. Beyond the fences of our Christian faith, I guess life in general is designed by God for relationship, especially if you are a Filipino. Unbelievable webs of relationship. I'll give you an example. Say you are of Pinoy, you went to the US for many years, and then you came to Davao and you failed to text your friends that you are here. Issue na yan. Ambuga eh. Wala mala nagpabalong ng uli. That's it. You have to text your friends. Say you are from this place and your budget is only, you know, limited, but you need to buy pasalubong because if you don't, you will be tortured. Something like that. Our culture is a very hospitable and relating culture, but also a very damaged one. In other words, the truth cannot be shorter than this. Somehow, everyone is connected with someone. Everyone is connected with someone. Facebook made that clear. Kahit, adyo kay friend, oy, bisang usa. Langan wrong friend. Today, the social media made this connection easier. But I'm not sure if it's deeper. Last Sunday was my day off. Appreciation for the church for allowing me to not to be with you one Sunday so I can rest, so I can have time, so I can watch Netflix. Na Sunday, I had breakfast with my family. That's a diversion, may McDo. So we were there. But some people know me, not in my barong. Ang abin nila, no, barong ragit akong sanina. Mag-t-shirt, you know. I know some people din. Pastor, unahan na gano. Day off ko po. Interesting about McDonald's nowadays, I'm just happy we brought our son. Okay, is what mag-order? Is lit. Malin mo, cancel, edit na unsa mo ni. Uy! And I thank God that Paul was there, so we ordered well. Pero I'm talking about old school, no? Old school. From the town where my wife come from in Blang, I think it won't work, even if I pindot-pindot ang McDo. Kung pa may makdo noon sa lang, no? Wala pa, no? Hindi gid pwede. E kung may pindot-pindot dira, hindi gid pwede. Ano man. Kaya mga tao sa lang, magbakal sang quarter pounder, di ba na mapalit lang. Uy, kumusta tong baboy mo, day? Mangumusta yun. Kumusta, 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 kumusta. Nowadays, in the presence of social media, that's gone. I will tell you the other side. The older generation miss the chit-chat. But the younger generation prefers it than talking. The younger generation have bowed down to the Baal of privacy to the point that they don't know how to relate anymore. And brothers and sisters, that's very sad. Because if you are saying to me today, Pastor, I can survive life, ako lang, wait until you're 45 years old and things begins to sink in. Life will be very lonely if you don't know how to relate with others. I am not at all insinuating that those of you who are single should be married. A lot of you are better off single than married, especially if you are a perfectionist. I beg you, don't marry. Because if you marry, you will destroy the very institution of marriage. Because marriage is not built for perfect people. Others are called to marriage. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about humbly admitting that I need others. I'm talking about a deeper issue. Humbly allowing the Holy Spirit to correct us that in my relationship, I should relate in a godly way because I want Christ to be glorified in my relationship. I want to make it clear that the sermon is not a marketing strategy. Maayo kapal dagang kaghalin. That's not the reason, though it happens. I want to make it clear that the sermon is, we need to relate because nakakahiya anong sasabihin nila, the Filipinos are hospitable. That's not, I am preaching this sermon convicted by the Holy Spirit, believing that the Spirit of God will convict us. We want to relate well because we want Christ to be glorified. All God's people say. Don't go out of that reason. As believers and followers of Christ, we are called to relate both worlds, outside world of the faith and inside world of faith. Outside, inside, we relate. In these webs of relationship, our desire is for Christ to be glorified. But if you handle this topic and you want authentic relationship, we must take into consideration the realities and not just settle for religious cosmetics. And I assure you, guilty as charged, our Filipino culture is not that credible in handling conflicts. We want to believe na umanato, kalimtana, pero sa sulod na the Filipino culture doesn't really know how to face conflict. I must add Chinese too. We don't want trouble. We don't want trouble. Wala lang, pero naagod. On the contrary, our American counterpart and the Western people have somehow dealt with conflict in another way. What's the issue? Let's talk about it. I think we need to learn from that. But sometimes that part of the West is also guilty of just being cognitive without heart. I think when you depend on culture, we are all flawed. So these bullet points shows us reality. And by reality, I mean, I don't need your opinion on this. This will happen whether you agree or not. You might not agree. That's not the point. But I'm showing you, out of this reality, realities, we talk about what Paul is saying to the Colossian church. Number one, the reality of human nature, those names mentioned represent stories of fallen humanity. Regardless of your biblical name, you have a fallen humanity. The Bible says all have sinned. Amen. When a parent gives a name to a child, that name, ang pangalan nga imong gipangalan sa mong anak, puno kaayong expectations. Are you feeling me? Tama? You want your frustration to be transferred. You know, if you are a pastor, I'm sure your children will be named after missionaries, not astronauts. They will be named after Bible names. Why? Because you want your expectations to be given. The Jewish people always have El in their name. Daniel, Joel, the El there means God. But even with good names, we have flawed nature. Accept that. Amen. Ito, nasakpan siya, no? Killer. Daghang kikipamatay. Kung sa'yo mong pangalan? Angel. Mga angelos name, but terrible heart. It won't help naming your kids biblical name. It won't change the nature. So that's truth number one. Now, are you ready for the second reality? There are maybe six realities. Even the godliest have conflicts. Are you saying me? Come, is there conflict among pastors? Oh, Lord, have mercy, yes. Is there conflicts among missionaries? Perfectly, yes. Everybody is not exempted, even if the most mature will have some heated times once in a while or all the time. Reconciliation is possible, but working together again in the same team is not guaranteed. So you can reconcile, pero magtrabaho ta usab, palagay ko that's another story. Are you with me? A lot of you believe that if we reconcile, kauban na pud tagbalik. I'm sorry, if trust is broken, I think that won't happen. Reconciled but not working together again. That's something to chew on. Sometimes separation or distance is a wise, mature choice. O ng kadaghanan ninyo, ang nangaway mo sa inyong simbahan na amudere. You're here in Chaibap because you have problems with your church. You have quarrels with your pastor. Now you're here. I am not saying you're wrong. I'm saying that sometimes relationship will get into that peak na muhawa na lang yod because that's the only way to have peace. So sometimes distance and separation is a wise choice. Abraham tells Lot, you go here, I'll go here. Mag-angkel, magkamag-anak ba yon? Tama? Barnabas and Paul, we'll talk about that later. Because of conflict with John Mark, goes here. Before it's Paul and Barnabas, now it's Paul and Silas. Nakatakot ano? And I have a feeling, ako lang ni ha? Sometimes if we are so close together that we become exclusive, the Lord will come in and disturb that so we can spread out and enjoy new friendships with other people. All God's people say. Especially if your friends are all Christians, are all Chinese, are all Americans. God, if you want God to be glorified, don't stick with one race. It's got to be interracial. Racism has no space in the church. Not at all. Kill its ugly head the moment it shows. What is the issue? This one is heavy. Dawaton lang ha? Spiritual maturity is the bottom line of handling relationship. Some people are good in preaching, others good in music, others good in theology, but very, very poor in handling relationship. It speaks of spiritual maturity. And therefore, somehow we have identified the problem. The problem why we cannot glorify God in our relationship, because we are not spiritually mature. But this one I reserve for last because many of you belong here. Grace and space are needed for those who are traumatized. A lot of you, with apology from my heart, is very hurt because a pastor took advantage of you. Nangutang wa ni bayad. Or a discipler took advantage of you. Or a trusted brother, muhang yung tako ninyo. You see, ang gubot sa friendship, kana mag-guarantee bitaw mag-utang, sugod gina sa kagubot. Have you not read from the scripture that if you have a friend and you guarantee his debts, I assure you, you will quarrel. And say, oy, pastor, good na, Kristo, hadi lagi na tama. A lot of you are traumatized, and the root of that trauma is business, financial. Magsuon ta kang Kristo, magkumpanya ta. Hay, sa katigwang na ko sa ministry, away, very few, as in very few, and fewer to few, survive that kind of arrangement. What makes you think you can make it? Now, here's my point. When this church was still younger, where Pastor Lim was still alive, gitayman yun na mo ba? Paghuman sa simba, wala ray usa ka minuto. Way mabilin. Murag mga hito nga nakawala. And then the guard will close the gate. Clunk! Meaning people are out. And some people, I don't want to bully you, di gyud kahulat og ending prayer. Muli na gyud. Muli na gyud. Gitatuyo, tuyo, busy, unsa? Kasabot ko ninyo. Kaya nga naman, dili pa ready makiglamano sa uban kay hadlok pa na trauma. Now, I am asking you to give space for people like that. Amen? They need to do that. We give them space. They're not yet healed. But to those of you who are in that predicament, I also want to tell you, staying in that stage for a long, long time, you are missing a lot of God's opportunity. Amen? It's about time to say, let me relate again. Paul went through it all. His scars are validation of his sermons. Nothing breaks the heart of God like when we are not honoring Him in our way of relating others. Now, here's something I cannot put on PowerPoint, but I can memorize. You are not responsible for the spiritual choice of others. Copy that? You're not. But you are accountable how you made them feel. Nahunaado ka dili. You're not responsible for their spiritual choice, but you are accountable if you made them feel deliberately inferior. Copy that? You are accountable if you demean people by the way you treat them. Nothing breaks the heart of many servants of God like unresolved conflicts. You know, several years ago, I met a missionary, and he has a very unique assignment from another mission. So we had dinner together, and I said, what is your assignment? He said, my assignment is unique, to patch up the quarrel among missionaries. Wow, a hard assignment. So how do you do that? But he said, first I ask you a question. So what's the question? Here's the question. What do you think is the highest reason why many missionaries resign and leave the ministry, including pastors? So I said, scandal, adultery, money, none of the above. Those were true reasons. I was not ready for the answer. Said, the top number one reason why missionary resign is another co-worker. Another co-worker. So if that is true among us who eat the Bible and speak the Bible, I am sure you can now say, ay, salamat, dili lang day kami. If there is what you call professional envy, there's also ministerial envy. Copy that? So having said that, Paul mentioned a lot of names, but inside that text, that concluding text, is a timeless lesson on how to glorify God in our relationship. Number one, relating with others is God's design for life and ministry. Amen? Latay mahimo ana. You are not designed to live solo. Gihulma ka sa Ginoo aron makighimamat sa uban. All God's people say, amen. One of these days, you will need the blood type AB of a Muslim which you despise. One of these days, you will need a type AB blood of a gangster which you despise. In other words, God, in His wisdom and sovereignty, did not design you independent, but dependent on God and dependent on others. Now, I'm 54. Those of you my age are looking at retirement, I suppose, at the age 60. And I'm looking at my kids. Yeah, yun ako, Lord, kung for the age yet, yun akong bagsak. Think about that. Your kids will grow up. They will have dreams. And children today, they don't dream like I'm going to Mlang, I'm going to Digos. No, I'm going to the U.S., Canada, and Tulunan. Ana ilang mga damgo. Ako mga anak, masulti naman sa kwadad. Andam lang ha, kay my mindset is abroad. But who'll take care of me? But do you know who will take care of you? Mag-meeting tabi, maghimo na lang tag home for the aged yun. No, para tinudanay na ba? Hindi na ito makatik-atik nga itong mga anak magbaguod yung sa Chinese, di pwede yan. Ha? No for home for the aged. I mean, I think it's about time to think about that, you who are thinking of ministry. Mahal pong bayad, ana. Nahunaan ninyo. Home for the aged. One day you realize, para na astigulang, but every day you're going there. But what is the lesson? The lesson is this. You need others. Here's the lesson. People are not just people in general. They have names. You want to glorify God in your relationship? Suggestion? Try your best to know their names. Amen. Name. Ako maulaw na ko dire kay mag-shake hands. Kasi kayo mong pangalan. Ay, pastor, ay, tulo na kakabulan. Sige, pangutanan sa ko, ah. Pasensya, pasensya. Sa kadaghan ba? Ako kayo ampo. Kung seryosohon ko ning awali ba? Get serious about people's names. Amen? Masaman, gusto ninyo mag-name tag ta. Murang atin o seminar sa Kapa. Atay, ayun na lang name tag. I cannot force you on this, but this is the only way. Okay, I feel the introverts. I feel the people who are shy. But any relationship starts with getting to know names because names corresponds nature and needs. Nature and needs. Solo is safe, but solo is not God's design for life. When I meet some people who are strong, ako pastor, I am a, what do you call that? Self-made person. I don't need a man. If you're a woman, I don't need a woman. If you're a man, I can survive alone. How old are you? Sometimes they're not yet 45 when they say that. Because the magic age is 45. Once you touch down with that age, you realize life is lonely. Believe me. And elderlies, ang mga katigulangan, see, it's not cancer that will kill you. It's loneliness. Di habito sa SM? Sa lanang? Di habito ko kapi-kapi sa Krispy Kreme? Nadyo ko'y makita, di hati gulang. Ay, gold, diri, mura magsi. Kuan? Basta, kumikinang-kinang. Gakapi. Wala gud siya kausap ba? Sige ko, kaluoy sa tiguan. Then I realized, wala din akong kausap. Ay, Lord. In Jesus' name. Life will be lonely. Listen, sasabihin ko sa wikang sarili. I will say in Tagalog, I have no other way to say it. Those of you foreigners, you just ask the Filipinos. Elisud yun siya i-translate. Ito na po. Ang daming mga pahina ng buhay, masasayang pahina ng buhay, ay hindi natin natitikman dahil matagal tayong nagpakumbaba. You want me to translate that in English? Very hard, no? There are so many pages in life supposed to be joyful and full of laughter and happy moments that we miss because we have delayed our humility. We preferred pride. Brothers and sisters, we need others. All God's people say, we need each other. Amen. Oh, thank God. Learn that earlier. We grow along, not alone. A spiritual life is not growing alone. It's growing along. So here, I will strike a little pin. Gamay lang, para lang kagat ng leon. Sandali lang ito. For those of you who are too at home to be alone, false comfort. You must find a way. Ito na lang. Mrs. Clara Matthews, one of our missionaries in Blang before, I was very young when she said this. Because she noticed that the Baptists in Blang do not know the Assemblies of God, do not know the Fourth Square, do not know the Catholics. We are just all Baptists together. Baptists in life, Baptists in death. We eat Baptist food, drink Baptist drink. I don't know. And then Mrs. Matthews said this. She said, we might feel we don't need them. Parang ganon. But did you not ever realize that they might need us? Think about that. In this neighborhood of Las Terrazas, Ladislawa, or other places, you've been there for years, but you don't know the name of your neighbor. I am not spouting and spiting you. I'm just saying, why? How in the world can we spread the gospel if we are isolated? Tama? I think it will be very, very offensive to my part if a lost stranger would come along. There is the atong lugar, no? Asa man ang Chinese Baptist Church? 25 years naman ko, diri na ba na? The problem is not him. The problem is the church who is too comfortable and too isolated. One funny moment, one morning, I was having breakfast pre-COVID at McDonald's. Oh, blessed is McDonald's. It all allowed the religious leaders to meet together. I met the sisters at the San Pedro College. I met the pastor of the Alliance. I met Father Rene Ocampo of the Jesuits. And then in the middle ako. So, di kin may magtingogay. Oh, Sister Ak, excuse me. The father will also do like that. Somebody has to break the silence. And then one of us would say, Sister, I said, ako ang pastor sa kininkuan. Chinese Baptist said, oh, the nun, nag-bless siya ko, Lord. Di ba ta ana-ana, mga Baptist, di ba? By the way, some of you mag-bless ako, di na lang ko masuko, pero shake hands lang would be fine. Kaya kung bless mo, iguwang ko manis ako ata. Di, kasi kaya paggalang. Ayun naman. The nun, I enjoyed talking. So, Reverend, pray for us. I'll pray for you. Did I compromise our doctrine? No, I just grew up a little bit and relate with neighbors. Copy that? All theories or grace allows the possibility of hurt as well as healing. This is Dr. Jerry's sermon last Sunday. Same grace allows you to hurt. Same grace allows you to be healed. So when you relate to others, it's not safe. It's risky. All theories. What are you? You're a Bible teacher. You are an expositor. I am a preacher. You are in radio. You are a manager. You are a UP professor. Whatever you learn, all the theories and principles in life are tested in relationships. Amen. Wala ginatanan kung dili ta kabalo makitungo sa ibang tao. Your education and your doctorate is a big shame if that costs you pride instead of burden for those who don't know. Number two, relating with others, bukat ang number two ha, is God's design to humble us and help us to spiritual maturity. How do you know a person who is spiritually immature? Simple. That person acts superior, feels superior, and lets you know that he is superior. These are immature people. I am so sad when I hear pastors say, I will go to Baguio and get an MDiv and doctorate so that others will respect me more. Who taught you that? I will enroll in SEE, our church, so that I can have credentials. I understand that. Para marespetuhan ta. Mali. Paul's ministerial skills and spiritual maturity were sharpened by those relationships. And I want you to think, nasaktan ka ba? Nasugatan ka ba sa imong relationship? Of course. Now look at it this way. That's one way God is teaching you to be humble and to help you grow spiritually. All God's people say. Oh, wow, what a blessing to meet scarred, wounded, mature believers who would say, I get over that already by the grace of God. Amen. Kada mga luod-luod system, ay, membro din nga, mabalik na lang si Jesus, Lord, anan lang gihapon. It's about time to grow. It's about time to grow. Here's the point. Paul learned the beauty of friendship and the pain of betrayal. I want you to look at verse 14. Can we read that together? Luke, the beloved doctor, sends his greetings, and so does Demas. Now, if you look at that verse, parang wala lang, but that's why I'm encouraging you, don't just look at the verse, study the background, okay? What's the background? Luke and Paul are good friends. Thank God there is a Luke. Kaya kung wala si Luke, wala Book of Acts, siya may nagsulat ana. So kung wala si Luke, wala Gospel of Luke. And wow, we miss a lot. Luke, thank you for being in the kingdom of God. But Luke cannot survive without a Paul, and Paul cannot survive without a Luke. That's the way it works. And if that is not a first-class rebuke for you who think you can manage it without others, I don't know what to call you. But on the other hand, he sends his greetings. So does Demas. Putol na. So does Demas. Who is Demas? Well, Demas was once part of the team. If my interpretation is accurate, at one time, he and Paul's going to along together and something happened in between. Sounds familiar? Nindot sa sugot, sigig outing, sigig istorya, and then finally, nagkalainay. 2 Timothy verse 4 and 10. I believe this is the same, Demas. Demas has deserted me because he loves the things of this life and has gone to Thessalonica. That malalim ang hugot. In that statement, Paul is saying Demas left the world. Maybe he realized he is not called for ministry. No, deeper than that. Paul is somehow saying Demas fell in love with the world and left me. And that caused him hurt. By the way, you should not be hurt if a friend resigns because the ministry is affected. No, 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 no. We should be ashamed if we keep someone and not give him the freedom to resign so that the ministry will move on smoothly. That is not the will of God. So that's hard to do. We need the staff. We need the associate pastors. We need Kate. We need the technicians. We need everyone. But a time will come that God will call them in another ministry. Authentic relationships should not be charged betrayal if somebody just wants to live his life for God's glory in their own interpretation. All God's people say, kung dili na ka sa chaibab mag-work, dili na na God's will. Pataka ka lang. Baka mas God's will. I mean, aso ko mas Pablo kay Demas, malalim. Ang punto ko dito, nagkadao tayo sila. And Paul learned from the pain of betrayal, not just on the sweetness of friendship. Read more. 2 Timothy 4:14-15. Nabas Bible, no? Tuumog sa dili, basahon nato, ha? Alexander. May nalang way apelido. Baka coppersmith yung apelido. Si Alexander nga the coppersmith did me much harm. Siguro nang utang o ano bayad. Nagkapa. But naunsa ni si Alex? What is the reaction of Paul? Learn. But the Lord will judge him for what he has done. Now, wait a minute. How will you react if someone hurt you and you're really hurt? The Lord will judge him for what he has done. And then what did Alexander say to Paul? The Lord will also judge you for what you have done. I'm sure, bias aside, napoy hugot si Alex, pero klaro man nga naghimo siya daotan. Pero ang reaction ba? Maturity! The Lord will judge you for what he has done. Amen? I pray that we learn that. Dili na natua. Amen? Pero, look at verse 15. Be careful of him. He fought against everything we said. It's not wrong to warn others about evil people. It's not wrong. Basigmalain siya. If he did something wrong, then he will pay the price. Kung nagpaayo kag spark plug, ipa-overhaul imong sakyanan, ug tinuod, mukatag na sa Facebook. So what Paul is saying, God is in charge, but there is discernment and wisdom not to become victim again, all God's people say. Did you hear that? God is in charge, but there is wisdom not to become victim again. And when I say this, please do not think of yourself as a victim, because someday you are too naive if you believe that you are not capable of doing this to others. Others did you evil. Tama. But be careful. We have the same nature. We are very capable of doing evil to others. That's why the focus is Christ. Paul learned to accept grace from others. You know, if you want authentic relationship, dili lang ka tighatag, kabulupog ka mugdawat, maski dato ka, mudawat ka sa pobre. Amen. Sometimes nakakahiyan, oh, pastor, naulaw ko, ikaw pa dyan naghatag, kapobre na mo, halakalo. Inom sa ta. Marang anak, no? Culturally, other people are generous, but you are not aware your generosity is already pride. Ako'y hatag. Ako'y hatag. But one day, believe me, folks, you will be placed in a position that you will be a receiver. Prepare for that. Amen? Are you offended once in a while? Sige kag libre, 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 libre. For the first time, ang paso na, ako na po'y libre nimo. Bas, maulaw. Ako na libre nimo. You pray, I pay. Mali yata, no? Ang punto ko, lagi panahon nga, you have to eat that undetected pride of being a giver. Because ultimately, ladies and gentlemen, we are all receivers from God. All God's people say. Paul needs to learn to dispense grace for others, especially with his relationship with Mark and Barnabas. You don't know the story? I told you in ganina. The Bible says, so does Mark, Barnabas' cousin, as you were instructed before, make Mark welcome if he comes your way. You know what happened here? Mark is a young, immature Christian. Barnabas, his cousin, says to Paul, ubano na to ni? Sige, Mark joined the team, but Mark became pasaway. Wala nagbehave ba? So yeah, as Pablo, because Paul is choleric and perfectionist. Dili na pwede. Out! Paul is a baseball player, you know? Strike one, strike two, strike three, you're out! Barnabas said, ayaw, Paul, pastagano to ni, pasensya ta ba, kay bata pa man eh. Nitubag si Pablo, kay imo man ang pagumangkon. Heated argument that resulted to separate. But one thing is nice, you might not have the same partner, but the work of God must go on. Mark went here, Paul went here. Some of you are here because you're not there. O, di ba? Ba't kayo nandito? Kasi umalis na kayo sa simbahan ninyo, di ta mo ma-blame. Pero if you stay in Chaibab and believing that you will not be hurt here, you are wrong. You will have your share. And if you are already elderly, grow up. You are now in the pre-departure area. Pwede ba? Nagatigulang ta, panahon na, nga kanang mga luod-luod, inudana na niba? No? You know, with all due respect to the senior citizens, pwede namang mauna yung bata. Pero ang tono ko, it's about time to experience the pages that are lost. It's about time to humble yourself so that the joy of the Lord will still be redeemed by you. Amen. Ano ba dang? Unya ko na lang na-explain kanay versikulo ana. Can you imagine if John Mark were not restored? He wrote the book of Mark. Something to think about. Sometimes the immature friends and believers we rejected, oh, Dr. Jerry, this is grace. The pasaway, the problems, halakagamiton dahil sa Ginoo. Only the eyes of God can see that, but maturity will accept that. Another one. Paul learned to work with co-workers interracially. Verse 11. Jesus, the one we call Hostos, also sent his greetings among my Jewish, only Jewish co-worker. Anong meaning niya? If Paul is so happy, I have my Jewish worker, it means that there are also non-Jewish worker. Amen? Now here's the point. If you are an American, I don't blame you if you feel much at home with Americans rather than Filipinos. That's not an offense. If I am a foreigner in another land, I would prefer to be with Filipinos rather than kay makasabot mangunta. Pero kung gusto nato mahimaya si Kristo, if we want to glorify Christ, we need to expand friendship beyond our race. All God's people say. Filipinos are very hospitable. Our church is very hospitable. Doon lang biya tali haon. San Pedro Hospital. Hospitable ka ita. Pero ang pagka-hospitable sa Pinoy, di pa na mauba. The hospitality we're talking about is not Philippine culture. It is Christianity. And there is a difference. So Paul is saying, I'm happy na ako yung mga Jewish friends. It's okay. I have some Chinese friends. Of course you should. I have some Buholano friends. Simple sa no. Gikanta sa dito. Tagamlang ay kami mga tagamlang ay kaupod kami taga Iloli ay Abao taga Molo siya taga Haro ako namigida mga Dabao okay yun pero hindi pwede limitado doon. If you want to glorify God in your friendship, I cannot insist what the scripture did not insist, but I think it is the teaching of the scripture that the church should be multicultural. All God's people say. I'm sure when you are in heaven, it's not Chinese only. I'm sure when we hear the praises and worship of the people in heaven in the book of Revelation, in their tribes, tongues, and nation, all languages are respected. Brothers and sisters, look at the second part. Inimedyo hait ahit, ha? Woo! Bugat kayo. Ako na bugatan po ko. Read that. And what a comfort they have been. They're working with me here for the kingdom of God. And what a comfort they have been. So when you work for the kingdom of God, please do not limit that to ministry. Being a plumber, being a doctor, being an architect, being a nurse, being a barber, being a businesswoman or businessman, that's still for the kingdom of God. Amen. And then this is the beautiful lesson. Before you partake communion, Lord, help me become a blessing to others. When people think about my name, what a comfort that person is to me. Ako'y pangutana. When people think about you, will they say the same? I tremble. I think I have been a blessing to many, but I'm sure I have been an offense to many also. So I pray to God that if we want to glorify Christ in our relationship, we ask God, Lord, ano na lang kinabuhi ho? Ilan na ka, sir? 72. Umay na lang ko lang. Usa na lang kawati mo pirma. Sold out na. Mangawoy pagyud. I am appealing to you in the name of Jesus. Don't miss the trip. Huwag na pong sayangin ang mga masasayang pahina ng buhay dahil tayo ay masyadong mayabang. Alam niyo yan? When you harden your heart, you will be like Pharaoh. No longer know how to relate. See? Kabalo ba yan ang anghel o kosmo? Kinsang lungon diha ang way bisita. Oh, mga tao diha, dugay na dirigihaya ba? Wadyo ko kakita bisita. Ay bisita, mali pa dyan. Ay, di ni maong dirito. And this is not a joke. I know someone who died and when he was still alive, Allah ina, nag-ampo dyan ko, Lord, uwi ay. Yun siya, Pastor, mamatay ko, naghimo na kong listahan sa mga taong dili maka-attend sa akong lubong. Ako yawa, eh, patay ka na, patay na. Napadyoy, so ang anak mo'y ma-burden ato. So ma-attend ka sa funeral, excuse me, hindi ka ka-attend. Layas, Kabalo mo kin sa looy ana ang buhi. Itang mga kabatyono na, di na ito magpatakag bilin o last will and testament na burden. Sabi na, kung mamatay ko, akong anak, paeskwila ha? Hoy! Huwag ako kapaskwila sa kuha. Mamatay na lang, selfish gihapon. Kung mamatay ko, dapat diri ko ihaya. Pwede ba? Gayahin nyo na lang si Aling Ching. Mamatay si Mrs. Loses, walang problema. Uyaw pa kaayog closing him. Fly me to the moon. Matay si Mrs. Loses, alam niyong kwento? Christmas Eve. Ang iyalang request dito, ako kuno ang maglubong. Pero naay ana, if he is still alive. Naisip ko yun. So kung kayo ay kukunin na ng Diyos, pwede ba yung mga last will and testament? Huwag nang pabigat, please. Na dapat bisitahan Diyo ko every Thursday sa Forest Lake. Nga ikaw na gay, patay ka na, demanding ka pa. Pagkapatay, mo nang tama ng Iglesia ni Cristo, pag namatay, tapos. Uy, bisita. Dito sa Forest Lake, dala kong iro dito. Multicab. Ang babae naghila ko, bago pa niya namatay. Storya yun niya iyang bana. Dunggan man ako. Naama ko dito! Samasad mo. Kusog sa mo, yaw. Depressed ba ako ato? Dadala kong iro. Si Sam, my midlife. Sabi ko, Dad! Mag-uwan matay. Masta ka niya, Dad. Kukini. Tubaga niya ron. Alam ka ba, sige na taka-communion? Ano siya ba? Dad, hiningi mo katapad ha? Babae biya ni. Basi mga bit ka! Basta nawala akong depression, oy. Ang bihira, patay na. Ano pa? Ang istorya biya, aming cutie, ana. Kuday, kung mamatay ko, bisitahan ko ni mo. Wala mo siya ni tubag. Hala ka, Lord. But I'm saying, I'm not blaming her for that. I'm simply saying, even in death, you are still selfish. Did you get the point? My brothers and sisters, nindot kayo ng what a comfort to know when I remember that name. Amen. Please, I beg you. Pray to God that we all live like that. When people remember us, they find comfort. Paul respected women in ministry. Verse 15. Please give my greetings to brothers and sisters at Laodicea and to Nympha and the church that meets in her home. Originally, women should not be even mentioned in those ancient days. But Paul mentioned Nympha and the women. And to be honest with you, in my 34 years of ministry, with all due respect to men, most of the active people in church and who really work hard for the Lord are women. The men are saved by grace. Mga sa simbahan, mga, kinsa yung mga faithful dito sa Times Beach. Mga teacher, kapuy na mo, ministry gihapon. Ay, wala man tanangigo, no? Pero the women has place. The Southern Baptist must learn this. I look forward on that day that we will be able to ordain women in ministry. And not politicize that. There's a lot of politics going on in those days. Paul recognized women partners. I will not stretch that into big debate where it's already a hot issue in the U.S. There are hotter issues that should be taken care of. Justice, this and that, and this cute little thing divides the church. Paul benefited from a friend named Epaphras. This is my envy. Do you have a prayerful friend? Let us read. Epaphras. 1, 2, 3. Epaphras, a member of your own fellowship and a servant of Christ Jesus, sends you his greetings. He always prays earnestly for you, asking God to make you strong and perfect. Stop. What is perfect? Not flawless. It means spiritually mature. What is the prayer of Epaphras? Graduate na siya sa good health, good food, success, new car. He prays deep. And he said, I pray that they will be strong and mature. Kanina, when I was looking at the congregation during prayer time, I whispered an Epaphras prayer. Father, I hope all of us, when we hear your word today, will be strong and mature. Next prayer, fully confident that you are, wow. Have you prayed that? Friends, did you pray that for your son? Or you just want him to be an engineer? Maybe that's not the will of God. Your bullying is wrong. Maybe you want your son to take care of your business. Kay, wana ima binlan. Is that the will of God? That is my question. And most of the time, that is not asked anymore. Is that the will of God? In most churches, if the senior pastor dies, his son takes over. Is that the will of God, my friend, is my question. We need an Epaphras to help us pray for the will of God. Assignment for all of us, find a friend like Epaphras. Pray to God that God will send you a friend like that or be that friend to others. How will Epaphras pray? Deep. In what gesture? Labor in prayer, like a woman giving birth. Verse 13, I assure you, he prays hard for you and the believers of Laodicea and Hierapolis. Lord, this is a conviction of the Holy Spirit, not mine. Because something about prayer, Holy Spirit can only convict you. It's about time to take prayer seriously. And the right content of that prayer is, Lord, help Chinese Baptist Church to follow your will. All God's people say. You want to pray for your son? Help my son to follow your will. You want to pray for your daughter? Not only safety, good husband, good wife. No. Help my daughter to follow your will. That is the prayer. Kalayo na nato, no? Dili man mali mamarayag sa Ginoo. Sige na mali. Mamarayag may kog milk tea. Okay na. Pero dili di hakutob. Malalim po. Ginoo, kabubuton ba ni mo nga pastor pa ko diri? Ginoo, kabubuton ba ni mo nga muadto ko diri? Ginoo, Epaphras is laboring in prayer. Why laboring in prayer? Because questions like that don't come, answers are not coming simply. It requires struggle. It requires you to give up ego. It requires you to give up wealth, positions, property in order to follow God's will in that effect. That is Epaphras. So when I partake communion today, I will remember Jesus who prayed, not my will, but thine. Amen. Paul encouraged the struggling Archippus. And he say, Archippus, be sure to carry out the ministry the Lord gave you. Maybe this is for you. When I say ministry, again, not only about church, maybe teaching. Maybe you want to resign. Parang pangutana, God gave you that ministry. Or maybe if God gave you that ministry, is He wanting you to continue? For Archippus, Paul said, don't quit, carry it out. Now lastly, thank God, I'm wrapping up na. Relating with others is God's design to teach us how to hope together. Amen. Hope together. You cannot mature alone. We should mature together. Here's my point. Hoping together help us overcome isolation and individualism. Believe me. This is a tall order for missionaries. Isolation and individualism. This is a tall order for those of us who have worshipped the Baal of privacy. There will come a time, despite the trauma, despite the hurt, in the name of Jesus, we need to relate again. Hoping together, strengthen us to spread the gospel together. Amen. The spreading of the gospel cannot be done by mission. Kita tanan. Amen. We salt and light. Hoping together. Are you ready for this? Is truth-telling together. Truth-telling. In all aspects of truth, especially in our country, truth-telling. Together. Hoping together is truth living. Truth living. Hindi ito perfect, no? But together. You know? Together. At Bistro Rosario, one waiter there is by the name of Renan. Ito mga babae sa pikas, sabi, Pastor, kining a waiter. Nahulog akong wallet na 9,000, gibalik niya. I could only say, God bless you. And I hope the reason why you returned that is because you know Jesus Christ. And by the way, nakalimot ko, I should have reminded RC, but I thought of it now. Araw ng Dabao, no, this week? No, busy ka ita. Will you pray for spiritual awakening in our city? Amen? It is our job to pray for spiritual awakening in our city. Because together, we need a community. How do you relate? I hope this will help. The key words are relate, real. Can you remember those words? Relate, real. Mag-relate na walay atik-atik. Real. Tinuod. Let's have this for kalingawi lang ninyo ni, pero tinunood ko niya ako ha, para matabangan ta. R, reconnect with others. Is it time? Are you already done with your trauma? Don't reconnect with the crowd individually. Reconnect with others. Try to have coffee with others. Ask God. Number two, enable others. Enable others. Number three, let others enable you. A, allowance for imperfection. When you relate to others, you're not relating to perfect people. Amen? May kulo talaga yan. Kaya may allowance tayo doon. When you're relating to street kids, they will not be subdivision kids. They will be street kids with street kids nature allowance. Copy that? Do not erase their culture. It will be theirs forever. We need to relate an allowance for imperfection. Team and timing is wisdom. You cannot relate solo. Timing is wisdom. Barnabas and Paul, nagkauliay, dili ba ya immediately? Pero muhangyo lang po't ko ba? Pero daghana kay kagkaaway ba? Maldita ka eh. Panahon na siguro mayon ka, Lord, i-convict ko sa Ginoo ba nga? Wala, eh. Dili man ko makakonvict ni mo kay taura ta. Pero ka nang one day, mga pika ba? Manahon na ka. Wala ka, Lord, no? Daghana di ko kaaway. And dili ka makaadtog mall nga di ka kinsa na adri. Diba? Let me tell you a little secret. Umadtog kog mall na ako'y advance party. Ko, i-text daw sa kuwag na ako mga kaaway diha. Mag-text ba? All clear, Pastor. Ato na ko. Na, I'm a pastor. I have so many enemies. Uban ninyo na padre. Pero, peace on earth. Dili lang sa itong mga peron. Next year na, ha? Eh, di pa kaya. What I'm saying, cannot be hypocrite preaching this, di ba? I have my pastor's friends who are no longer my friends now. What's the issue? I am responsible for my bitterness. I need to surrender that to God before I touch this element. And I need to say, God, help me. Because real respecting others starts with our respect. Lord, restore respect in my heart. Amen? Kabaluka mo tahod sa isip, isip kaingon. Alala ko dyan si Junisha, manay, mami di. Birahan pa niya si Miriam Santiago, ang mali ni mo, ma'am, dili mo bo kaya kagpananaw kay Manny. Wala ka tingog si Miriam. Tinood man. Ngayon, bisayaw na ako, ha? Mangyon ta ako natong tanan. Na ba kay ginatanaw nga, ana, I think we should repent before we take. We must see the image of God in that person. Amen? Number two, empathize. Buhay pa yan, ha? Empathize na. Empathize. Dili lang yaw-yaw. Concrete. Gutom ka na. Padalig pan. Empathize. Asa na ta? L-A. Oh, careful how you pronounce that. Adapt. Adopt. No. Adapt. Mana gamin adapt. Eh kung adapt, ampun yun eh. Adapt. Missionaries, this is word is for you. Adapt. Do not always yaw-yaw with your neighbors. You adapt. ni anhi pamudire. Korean missionaries, listen to me. You need to adapt. Don't come to Davao like kings. Sikat ng BTS, hilas pa mo. Learn to adapt. Filipinos, we need to learn to adapt. In all of life. In marriage, you learn to adapt. Those of you visiting our church, do not bring your virus here. Learn to adapt. If you visit another church, learn to adapt. Diba? And the hardest part of relating is the L. Let go. There are some relationship, ang solusyon na lang gid-ana is distance. But no more bitterness, ha? All God's people say, amen. Klaro? Pag-communion na to niya, perting confess na to, ha? Bantay. Lord, pasaylo adyo ko. Those were my words, but I want to end with the scripture. When I read the scripture, manghilak kita. Sige lang, let the word of God duslak us. All God's people say, sige lang, sakit-sakit ni, pero mauman dyan, alangan akong irison. Read slowly, and then we have communion, okay? Nag-text na mabong alas dos tamahuman? Ready na ha, nahinay. Nahinay! Sobro pa ni sa wali, Biblia na ni. 1, 2, 3. Don't just pretend to love others. Agay, really love them. Hate what is wrong, hold tightly to what is good. Love each other with genuine affection. And take delight in honoring each other. Wow. Never be lazy. Work hard. Serve the Lord enthusiastically. Anong meaning ng verse 11? Don't manipulate the goodness of others. Tama? Trabahuin nagmaayo. No? Ang welfare center, kamo mga dato, di na mo mag-welfare center because you can afford. The welfare center is for those who cannot afford. Clear? And those of you rich people taking advantage of the welfare center is immoral. You can buy the medicine of your own. That medicine is for the poor. Don't take advantage. Dato na ka ma'am, naglingap ka pa. Umbihira ka o. Nilakas man ka sa gobyerno, ang para sa pobre, naadto ni mo. Hili na tama. Makainit og ulo. Pero kung pastor magsakit, lingap, lingap. Read it again. Never be lazy. Wow, ang sakit ano? But work hard. Serve the Lord enthusiastically. That is double to those who are in ministry. Rejoice in our confident hope. Be patient in trouble. Yan na, lalabas na yan. Keep on. Amen. Thank you, Lord. When God's people are in need, be ready to help them. Always be eager to practice hospitality. Nagsabot na biyata ha? Pag may sunog, kalamidad sa siyudad sa Davao, Chaibap will immediately release funds for the relief. All God's people say. That's not a burden to us. Amen? Keep reading. Oy, blehalalala. Tabang Lord. Delete na lang na. Bless those who persecute you. Don't curse them. Pray that God will bless them. Daghan ba akong ipang-apuan ninyo yung mga matay na munabuhi man noon? Mga kalaban ako ba, Lord, kuhaan na nila, healthy noon. Maybe God is teaching me. Dangay na ba? Bless them. That's not easy. Are you feeling me now? Is that easy? You know, that cannot be easy without Christ. Read. Be happy with those who are happy. Weep with those who are weep. Kanang imong multi-cab ba, nakatapad kag Porsche. Alam mo yung Porsche? Yung kotse dyan sa mga mayaman dito, Porsche? Nakatapad ka? Mayon ka? Smuggle mo na. Sana sinilas. Pwede ba? Mayon na lang ka, I'm happy for you. Sana all. Siloso kayo ba? Sige, basa more. Lord, I want to just be happy with those who are happy. Amen? And weep with those who are weeping. Magulang gani na buntis, kay pila ka semana, pila ka years nag-pray, nanay baby, buntis na. Thank you, pastor, nanami baby ni Husband, here are the people. Magbantay ka, ha? Mahydrocephalus ng bata. Wala, pagani. Why don't you just be happy for those who are happy? Live in harmony with each other. Don't be too proud. Alalala. Careful sa ginabasa. Don't be too proud to enjoy company. Ordinary. Sino yung ordinary? Kitatanan. We must enjoy the company of the ordinary. Amen? Wow, Lord, have mercy. Whoa. You don't think you know it all. What's the Chinese word for that? Kegao. Dili kagao, ha? Oh, I am teaching you Chinese. Kegao, you know it all. You know it all. Sabi ni Paul, no, don't do that. Keep reading. Ayay. Yoko, Lord. Are you planning to do something evil to someone? Pahirapan ko talaga ito ba? In the name of Jesus, God is telling you now, drop it. Amen? I am not dissolving the conflict or the offense, but stop inflicting evil deliberately to others. We will have communion later. Do all you can live. You know what? I highly recommend the Amplified Bible. Read it there. Iba ang Romans 12:18. Amplified, ha? If possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Amen. Why is that? Because there are others who don't want to have at peace with you. Don't blame yourself. Move on and glorify Christ. Amen. You have done your part. You have done the what is expected of you, but they won't budge. That's not your problem anymore. My dear brothers and sisters, here is the good news. Jesus, our master, related. All God's people say, amen. Jesus, our master, connected even to the worst people. And because of that, Jesus wept. Because when you relate, you will cry. Jesus is our model and mentor in relating with others. Amen. Who is our model? Christ. Jesus enrolled us to be part of this body. Jesus is glorified when we serve together in His name. So please do not serve God solo. Let's try to serve God together. How did Paul end his letter? Makabless. He ended it by saying, may God's grace be with you. All rise, please. Let us all take the bread. I love that sound. Tuyo po ninyo, no? You know the meaning of that sound? Can you imagine kung usa lang ka nag-communion? Hilom ka, ana lang. But because ang daming sound, you know the meaning of that? Very connected to my wali. We're not alone, we're together. On the night the Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed, He took bread and broke it and said, this is my body which is broken for you. Eat it in remembrance of me. Let us pray, Lord, as we partake this bread, we confess our bitterness. We confess our hurts. Siguro 1970s pa ni, but Lord, today, do something na dili ni magpadayon. Father, our life is short, and I want to be a blessing to others. Like when they remember me, they will not say I'm good, but they will honor the one who made me good. In Christ's name, let us eat this in remembrance of our Lord. Let's take the cup. Same manner, the Lord Jesus Christ took the cup and said, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Drink ye all of it in remembrance of me. Let us pray. Father, as I drink this cup of juice, symbol of your blood, remind me that whatever offense, your blood is thicker than our sins. Hallelujah. Lord, you are a forgiving God. As I partake this, enable me to become a forgiving person too. With wisdom and grace, Father, I pray now, in the remaining days of our lives, Lord, have mercy. Cause us to be a blessing to others. through Christ our Lord. Let us drink this in remembrance of our Lord. Before we close the service this morning, Kate will be leading us in a song. I have this last instruction for you. When Architect Fortuna was still designing the building, I told Richie, "Chi, ayuho ang altar." My prayer is the altar. If you are a Baptist, the altar is an important part to you. Why do you need to come forward? No need to be forced. Listen to the Holy Spirit. A gesture of commitment, a gesture of gratitude, a gesture of repentance, very private between God and you, and yet very public, open to all, not to exalt self, but to honor God. Those of you up there, you cannot come here, I understand that. But if the Lord convict you, you can kneel and sit where you are standing, saying, as if you're joining people here. As the music starts, maybe husband and wife or as family, you are convicted, sige, mag-adto ta sa altar just to surrender, just to, you know. Aslom na kayo ang invitation kung ang pastor magbuot. Because after I say this, maghilom na ko, the song will be sung, Holy Spirit will convict, but I'm inviting you. It is a good God-honoring practice to respond to the conviction of the Holy Spirit. Don't stay here for long, 2-3 seconds or 4, maybe 5, maybe a little bit longer. Pray, God, month of March na, please help me. A lot of things. And then quietly go back to your seat, and then we will all close in prayer. Amen. Amen. Kate, will you come and lead us in this beautiful song by Michael Card, Grace Be With You All. Grace be with you. As the song starts, come, surrender to God. Dismiss us today as you have exposed us to the reality and difficulty of relating. Imagine how could have been that to you. You are holy and you came to this very, very sinful world. And the sinful world even rejected you. So Lord, we're not perfect, but something must happen starting today. Help us relate. And in this relationship, the goal is to glorify Christ. Amen. Not to make name, not to respond to guilt, but to glorify Christ. Abba, gamay na lang kayong katuigan. Life is short. Lisod kayong daghang kaaway. God have mercy. It's time to just maturely, amen, maturely say, help me move on. Try not to destroy other people. Lord, hear our prayers. Even our offerings are not accepted if we have bitterness in our hearts. So before we drop our offerings at the box, we need to confess our sins as we have done so in the communion. Thank you for reminding us. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We worship you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Let us lift up our hands to the Lord. Hear our prayers. Hear our prayers. If it is okay with you, I'd like to encourage you to tell your neighbor right back in front, God's grace be with you. God's grace be with you. God's grace be with you. God, especially if your name is Grace, God's grace, grace, grace be with you all. God bless you. Thank you for coming. The pastors are in front. If you need prayers, please come. They will pray with you. As you drop your offering, pray for generosity and gratitude.